Very good morning to all. Today we will discuss a numerical for calculation of module, design of gear, calculating all the dimensions for the gear using velocity factor method in order to account for the dynamic load. So in this particular numerical, the gear and the pinion are made up of different materials, and the Lewis form factor for these two cases is also given. So how such problem is required to tackle, that we are going to discuss. So numerical, it is required to design a pair of spur gears with 20 degree full depth involute teeth consisting of 20 teeth pinion meshing with a 50 teeth gear. The pinion shaft is connected to 22.5 kilowatt 1450 rpm electric motor. The starting torque of the motor can be taken as 150% of the rated torque. The material for pinion is plain carbon steel, Fe410. SUT is given, 410 newton per mm square, while the gear is made up of gray cast iron, Fg200. SUT is equal to 200 newton per mm square. The factor of safety is 1.5. Design the gears based on the Lewis equation using velocity factor to account for the dynamic load. Y value is given, Y20, Lewis form factor for 20 number of teeth and Lewis form factor for 50 number of teeth. That is, what is the value is required for this pinion and gear for Lewis form factor, it is given, and CV 3 upon 3 plus V. So let us write down what is given, and then we will go step by step in detail. Given for this numerical, it is required to design a pair of spur gears with 20 degree, so alpha pressure angle is given, 20 degree, full depth involute teeth consisting of 20 teeth pinion, number of teeth on pinion, ZP is equal to 20, meshing with 50 teeth gear, ZG is equal to 50. The pinion shaft is connected to 22.5 kilowatt. Kilowatt is equal to 22.5 1450 rpm electric motor. So here I can say NP is equal to 1450 rpm. The starting torque of the motor can be taken as 150% of the rated torque. This is nothing but the service factor. The service factor is equal to starting torque divided by rated torque, or maximum torque divided by rated torque. So here 150% means it is nothing but 1.5. The material for pinion is plain carbon steel. The material for pinion is plain carbon steel. So I will write down, whose SUT is given. SUT, I will say, this for pinion is equal to 410 newton per mm square. While the gear is made up of gray cast iron, whose SUT is given, 200 newton per mm square. So I will write down SUT for gear is equal to 200 newton per mm square. So both the pinion and gear are made up of different material having the different ultimate tensile strength. Okay. The factor of safety is 1.5. FS is given as 1.5. We have to design the gear based on Lewis equation. So here BHN is not given. It is clear cut as What is required? Designed gear. Means what? We will calculate module based on Lewis equation and using velocity factor to account for the dynamic load. CV is given as 3 upon 3 plus V. Velocity is not given. If required, we will assume the velocity as 5 meters per second. In addition to this, the Y value is given. Lewis form factor Y for 20 number of teeth is equal to 0.32, and Y for 50 number of teeth is equal to 0.408. So we have discussed up till now different numericals in which the material is same, therefore only one SUT value is there, and Y also value only given for pinion. And if the materials are same, we generally say that pinion is weaker than the gear. For this case, material is different. Therefore, we have to decide first whether we will go for pinion or whether we will go for gear. And after this decision, all the further things will be same. So we have to calculate module, face width, the dimensions we have to calculate. As per our this whatever general procedure, I will give you first some steps for this proceeding. So how we will proceed one by one? So very first, deciding which part is weaker. So I will say step number one, design based on pinion or gear. So we will decide that design for pinion or gear. If both the pinion and gear materials are same, we are writing that pinion is weaker and we are proceeding with the numerical. But for this case, it is different. So we have to decide first which part is weaker and then we will proceed. Then step number two, now here you can easily proceed further. I will calculate in this case MT is equal to 16 to 10 raised to 6 kilowatt divided by 2 pi n. Here may be NP or maybe NG. Depending upon the case, whichever is weaker, I will take this. Then next I will calculate static load PT, and that PT will be in terms of module. Then number four, I will go for beam strength calculation SB, and I will calculate SB in terms of module. Then I will proceed for calculation of P effective. Here I will assume the velocity as 5 meters per second. I will calculate CV. Then proceeding further, P effective is equal to CS PT by CV. PT is in terms of module, therefore P effective also we will get the value for P effective in terms of module only. I will write mean more precise something divided by module, so it will be also in terms of module. Then next, based on beam strength it is clear cut mentioned, therefore next step I will write SB is equal to P effective into FS. P effective in terms of module, SB in terms of module, I will get the value of module here in this step. And after calculation of the modules, next I will calculate all dimensions and we can go for check for design also. After calculation of dimensions, I can say that by using the dimension I will calculate PT, I will calculate V, I will calculate CV, I will calculate effective and then I will calculate AFS again and I will check whether the design is safe or not. So this is the additional step. So these are our standardized or generalized steps for solving the numerical. Let us move to step number one. Step number one, we have to decide which part is weaker. So let us decide which part is weaker, step number one. So I will, as I am writing in every numerical that as we are writing that as both the gear and pinion are made up of same material, therefore pinion is always weaker. So here in this case, gear and pinion are made up of different material. This is required, huh? Different material. Therefore, we have to decide the weaker part. Now, how we will decide the weaker part? It is depending upon the product of sigma b into y. Still, for your understanding, I will write down Sb is equal to mb sigma b y. Mb sigma b y. So now m module. Module is same for pinion and gear. Face width is same for pinion and gear. Then and then only they will mesh. Sigma B material is different. Therefore, for pinion it is different. SUT for pinion and gear is given different. And based on number of teeth, Y value is also different. Now, therefore, I have to calculate this product. Sigma B into Y for pinion and sigma B into Y for gear. So I will write down here for pinion. For pinion, I have to calculate sigma b into y. For gear, also I have to calculate sigma b into y. So for pinion, sigma b is equal to SUT divided by 3. 410 divided by 3. So you will get it 136.67 Newton per mm square. Okay. Check the value 0.32. Y value is given. So I will say here Y value 0.32. So let us calculate sigma B into Y, this product for pinion. So it will be 136.67 into 0.32. So, sigma B into Y, this product for pinion is equal to, huh? What will be the product in this case? 43.73. So, I will say 43.73. No unit required. Still, if at all you want to give the unit. So, Y, it is a Lewis form factor, no unit. Sigma B Newton per mm square. So if you want to give unit, then you can give unit as, because it is there is no special name for this. It is just a product we have calculated. Now similar, I will calculate for gear. Similar, I will calculate for gear. So I will say here, sigma B for gear is equal to SUT divided by 3. 200 SUT is given for both the cases in the numerical. So SUT for gear 200 divided by 3. So I will say 66.666. So I will say 66.67 Newton per mm square. Okay. Then what is Y value for this gear? 50 number of teeth. Here this is for 20 for pinion. So it is 0.408. So I will say Y value is given as 0.408. So let us calculate the product sigma b into y for gear is equal to 66.67 into 0.408. So you will get the value as 27.20. Okay. So the value will be sigma b into y is equal to, for gear is equal to 27.20 Newton per mm square. So friends, let us compare this value. So for sigma b into y for pinion, it is the value 43. And here for gear 27.20. So from this value, whichever is lesser. So if I compare, I will say that sigma b into y for gear is less than sigma b into y for pinion. And based on this, I will comment. For this numerical, gear is weaker than pinion and it is required to design gear. Very important. When the gear and pinion are made up of same material, we are directly saying that pinion is weaker than the gear. But if the gear and pinion are made up of different materials, we have to decide which part is weaker. And here we have calculated SUT is given for pinion, SUT is given for gear for different materials. Lewis form factor is given for pinion and Lewis form factor is given for gear also for a different number of teeth. So we have calculated here sigma b into y, this product for pinion, sigma b into y, this product for gear, and the sigma b into y for gear is less than sigma b into y for pinion. Therefore, we will design based on the gear. This is very first part. And let us proceed our standard procedure now from this point onwards to design. So next will be first, very first point. So I will say here, step number one over for calculation. We all want to calculate the module only. So here, step number two, I will calculate torque transmitted, that is MT. I will calculate torque transmitted, that is MT. So what is formula here? So I will write the formula MT is equal to 60 into 10 raised to 6 kilowatt divided by 2 pi. Now up till we have taken until now NP, but here we are designing for gears. I will take here NG, 2 pi NG. So now how to calculate this NG? So I am having one relation. NG by NP is equal to ZP by ZG. This from that NP ZP is equal to NG ZG. Then only gear will perform its function. whatever required transmission ratio, then and then only we will get. So I will write Ng is equal to Zp into Np divided by Zg. So I will write here 20 into 1450 divided by 50. So I will get the value for Ng RPM as. What value I will get? Ng. So it is 580 RPM. So I will write here 580 RPM. So we have calculated Ng value. Now let us substitute all values and proceed for calculation of Mt. Mt is equal to 60 into 10 raised to 6 into kilowatt 22.5 divided by 2 pi into 580. So if you will substitute, you will get the value of Mt in Newton millimeter. You will get the value of Mt in Newton millimeter. So proceed and calculate the value by substituting all these values. Ng is not with us. We have calculated Ng by using the velocity ratio. And by if you substitute all the values, you will get the value of torque transmitted, Mt in Newton millimeter. So this value will be 370.446. Okay, 370.44. Okay, so I will say here Mt value as 370.45 into 10 raised to 3 Newton millimeter. Newton millimeter. Now I will proceed for next step. Step number 3. What it will be? Static load. PT. And I will get the value in terms of module. So I will say PT is equal to twice Mt divided by Zg, sorry, Dg. So by the calculation, so dg is nothing but m into zg. So I will substitute the value here, m into zg. So I will write down then pt is equal to 2 into 370.45 into 10 raised to 3 divided by m into 50. So I will get here the answer as PT is equal to, you will get one value divided by module and unit will be here Newton. So what will be the value? 14818. Okay. So 14.81 into 10 raised to 3. 1487. Okay. 14.81. Okay. So this is our PT value. I will make it highlighted 14.81. Okay, very good. So I will say 14.8177. I will modify it somewhat. 14.82 into 10 raised to 3. So this is my step number 2. Now proceed further. Next step is calculation of beam strength. So I will say here the formula as SB is equal to MB sigma b y. So I will put here m as it is, face width let us assume 10 times of module, sigma b for gear we have to take, we are designing for gear, every time I am telling that we are designing for gear, therefore sigma b is equal to 66.67 and y for this is given 0.408. Okay, so you will get SB is equal to, in terms of module square, you will get SB is equal to in terms of module square. And I will put here unit Newton. So SB in terms of module square, what will be the value for this? Okay, so 272.01 module square. 272.01 module square. So this is our step number 3. We have calculated beam strength in terms of module, static load in terms of module. Let us move further. Calculation of module. Next step I will say it is effective load calculation. We'll say step number 5, effective load, P effective. Very first I will write the formula, P effective is equal to CSPT divided by CV. CS value is given, PT we have to calculate, let us concentrate on CV. So velocity is not given, assume velocity is equal to 5 meters per second. So my CV will become 3 upon 3 plus V, 3 upon 3 plus 5 is equal to, what will be answer for CV? Okay. So then I will say P effective is equal to CS service factor in the given 1.5 into PT 14.82 into 10 raised to 3 divided by module. Divided by CV. So I will say into 1 divided by 0.375, or you can write divided by also, no problem. So I will get P effective is equal to, module will be at डिनोमिनेटर यूनिट विल बी न्यूटन. हाँ, कैलकुलेट इट विल बी ऑल्सो इन टर्म्स ऑफ मॉड्यूल. तो पी इफेक्टिव वैल्यू आई विल गेट एज इन टर्म्स ऑफ मॉड्यूल पी इफेक्टिव वैल्यू. फाइव नाइन टू 59.27271128. ओके, एनीबडी एल्स, एनी अदर कैलकुलेशन? 28. ओके, सो आई विल राइट डाउन 59.28. हियर पॉइंट इज देयर, 28 इनटू 10^3. ओके, देन स्टेप नंबर सिक्स. Here I will calculate module. So I will say here only beam strength is there, no BHN is given, we have not calculated SW. So whatever equations we are having, I will say SB is equal to P effective into factor of safety. So SB I will say 272. 0.01 into module square is equal to 59.28 into 10^3 divided by module into 1.5. I have just substituted the value of SB, P effective. Then you will get m cube is equal to one equation, and directly you tell me where we can calculate only module is unknown. So I will directly say that module is equal to value for module. Six point eighty eight, 6.89. Okay, very good. So 6.88. Let us assume round up it at say 1 millimeter. So this is your value for module calculation. Module is equal to 7 millimeter. Now we will take one by one all dimension. So I will not say steps here. I will say here dimensions. Module is equal to 7 millimeter. Next, B face width 10 times of module 70 millimeters. Next, I can calculate DP M into ZP. Okay, so say 1 into 20 140 millimeter. I will say DG M into ZG, say 1 into 50 350 millimeter. Okay, so we have written here pitch circle diameter, PCD for pinion, PCD for gear, face width and module calculation. So these are the dimensions. Now, So we will proceed for now for this numerical check for design, what we have calculated. So it is this next step you take, or this is the additional one. So I will say check for design, whatever dimensions we have calculated, we will go for checking, we check. So we are having all the formula, just putting, substituting the values of module here. I can say static load, comma, PT is equal to, we are having, we have calculated already PT, 14.82 into 10 raised to 3 divided by module. So module is 7 millimeters. Module is 7 millimeters. So 14.28 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 7. So I can calculate here PT is equal to. Tell me the value for PT in Newton. Any other? 2.117. 2.117. Okay, so I will say 2.11 or 2.12 into 10 raised to 3. 2.117. I will say 2.12 into 10 raised to 3. Next, go for pitch line velocity V calculation. We are having formula pi dn. So here I will say dgng, designing for gear, divided by 60 into 10 raised to 3. So here pi into 350 into 580, ng also we have calculated, divided by 60 into 10 raised to 3. You will get V is equal to meters per second. What is the value of V? 10.62. Any other? Okay, no problem. So we will take 10.63. 10.63. Now we are having three different formulas for this V. V is less than 10, V is greater than 20, and it is between 10 to 20. So here our 10 is less than V, less than 20. So I will assume that CV is calculated by 6 upon 6 plus V. In the numerical, we have assumed V as 5, and we have used the formula CV is equal to 3 upon 3 plus B. But what our actual calculation of module, we are getting here V value as 10.63 meters per second. So greater than 10 but less than 20, I will use CV is equal to 6 upon 6 plus V. Then CV is equal to 6 upon 6 plus V value 10.63. So I will get CV is equal to 0. I will get CV is equal to answer 3607, 361. Okay, no problem. Then let us calculate P effective. P effective is equal to CS PT by CV. So I will say CS 1.5, PT value 2.12 into 10 raised to 3 डिवाइडेड बाय सीवी वैल्यू 0.3607, सो आई विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ पी इफेक्टिव एज पी इफेक्टिव इज इक्वल टू इन न्यूटन आई विल गेट द वैल्यू here I will say it is 8.79. okay, anybody else? Effective load 8.81. okay, into 10 raised to 3 8.8. okay, so I will take one value 8.81 into 10 raised to 3. Now let us proceed for beam strength calculation. Very interesting, huh? Yes, B is equal to MB sigma B Y. It is not required actually. We have calculated it as 272.01 module square. This we have calculated in the beam strength equation. SB is equal to 272. So here if you refer, we have calculated the value. That value I will take. I will not go for detail again, formula. So SB is equal to, I will substitute 272.01 into module is 7 bracket square. So I will write down answer for beam strength. SB is equal to, in Newton I will get the value. Beam strength answer, huh? 272.01 into 7 square. What you will get as answer? 13.328 kilonewton, 13.32. Okay, so I will take answer 13.32 into 10 raised to 3 newton. Now again I will say SB is equal to P effective into EFS. So I will put value of ESB 13.32 into 10 raised to 3. I will put value of P effective 8.81 into 10 raised to 3. And I will calculate the value of EFS. Let me know the FS value is given in the numerical as 1.5. But while after calculation of module, we are calculating FS by considering our all calculations, because we have assumed velocity as 25 millimeter per second and CV as 3/3 plus V in the numerical. But if you calculate actually, the velocity is 10.63, CV formula is 6/6 plus V and the calculations are changing. So therefore we are calculating here factor of safety. So let me know what is the answer for this factor of safety. Okay, 1.51, 1.513. Okay, so I will say here 1.511. Okay, no problem. I will take any one case. 1.513. So here I will write down given factor of safety is 1.5. So EFS. Calculated is greater than factor of safety considered or given in the numerical. Means 1.5 should be the factor of safety and our calculation is 1.51. If it is lesser than, means 1. Assume that it is 1.4 and if we require 1.5, then the design is not safe and we have to go for revision in the module. We have to increase the value of module to next extent and then we have to go for calculation. But here FS calculated is greater than factor of safety given. Therefore, I will write down here design is safe. This is nothing but the check for design in this calculation. So this is nothing but check for design. Design is same. And why I have gone for check for design? We have assumed here velocity as 5. We have used the CV formula 3 upon 3 plus V. And we have calculated, but actual case velocity is 10.63. The CV formula is also changing, and accordingly all values are changing. Therefore, we have calculated whether our factor of safety calculated is equal to or greater than factor of safety given. Then and then only we can say that our design is safe. Otherwise, we have to consider the next level of module from the standard choice series, and we have to proceed for the calculation.